Look at this now. This is a quadratic equation given 3x square minus 5x plus 2 is equal to 0. Now let us solve this quadratic equation by using quadratic formula. Before you go to the quadratic formula, let us identify values of a, b, c now. Compare with the standard form ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. You compare with this one, you can find out the values of a. A is equal to 3. Then b is equal to, look at this, it is minus 5. And c is equal to 2. So these are the values of a, b and c. We compared with the standard form and found out the values of a, b and c now. Now you write down the formula. What is the formula to find the solution of a quadratic equation? That is quadratic formula, that is minus b plus or minus root b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. This is the formula. You need to substitute the values here. So let us substitute the values here. X is equal to minus, x is equal to minus, this minus I have written, b value, again minus 5 is there. In place of b, let me write minus 5, bracket, inside the bracket we can write minus 5. Then plus or minus root b square minus 4ac. B square means minus 5 square. B square means minus 5 whole square. Minus 4 into a value 4ac. A 3, c value 2. 3 into 2. So 4 into 3 into 2. So this is b square minus 4ac divided by 2 into a value. What is the value of a? A is equal to 3. So you substitute the value of a here, it becomes 2 into 3 now. So let us simplify this once again. Minus of minus 5 gives you plus 5. Then plus or minus as it is root. Minus 5 whole square means 25, plus 25. Then minus 4, 3 is 12, 12, 2 is 24. 24 divided by 2, 3 is 6. Now, x is equal to 5 plus or minus root 1 divided by 6. So, x is equal to 5 plus or minus root 1 means it is 1 only divided by 6. So, you are having two solutions. x is equal to 5 plus 1 by denominator is 6, or x is equal to 5 minus 1 divided by 6, plus or minus 1, another one is 5 minus 1. So now you simplify this one, x is equal to 5 plus 1 means 6 by 6, so x is equal to 1, or x is equal to 5 minus 1 means 4 by 6, so x is equal to 2 by 3. So it's the solution of this quadratic equation. So we solve this by using quadratic formula. As look at this question, x square plus 4x plus 5, let us compare with the standard equation. Ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Compare this with the standard form. A value is equal to 1, b value is equal to 4, c value is equal to 5. So now before we apply this one to quadratic formula, let us find out the value of b square minus 4ac. So b square minus 4ac we'll find out now. B square value, what is b square value? That is 4 square minus 4 into a value is 1, c value is 5. So what you will get? 4 4 is 16 minus 4 5 is 20. So you are getting minus 4. B square minus 4ac is minus 4, which is less than 0. Less than 0. You are getting a negative number. Once you get this value, a negative number, then roots will not exist here. You will not get a real roots, because it's a negative number. All real numbers, see, square of a real number cannot be a negative number. Square of, if you take the square, because root of b square minus 4ac we are having inside that. If you take the square of that one, it should not be a negative number. So So if you get a negative number, no real roots exist. Therefore, x square plus 4x plus 5 is equal to 0 is not having any real roots. Because the square of any real number cannot be a negative number. So that is the reason. Look at this question, 2x square minus 2 root 2x plus 1 is equal to 0. It's a quadratic equation. So imagine that ax square plus bx plus c and compare with this one. So a value will be equal to 2, b value is equal to minus 2 root 2, c value is equal to plus 1. Before we substitute this one to quadratic formula, you find out the value of b square minus 4ac. B square minus 4ac. So b square means it is minus 2 root 2 whole square. B square. Minus 4 into a value is 2 and c value is 1. So if you simplify this, minus 2 root 2 whole square. Minus 2 root 2 into 2 root 2. So 2 root 2 into 2 root 2. So 2 to the 4 into root 2 into root 2 it is 2, 8. So here you can write minus of square of minus, it is a positive number, it becomes 8. Minus 4 to the 8. So you are getting the answer 0. B square minus 4ac is equal to 0. Now you take this value and substitute in the formula. So formula, we have x is equal to minus b plus or minus root b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. This is the formula. So substitute the values here. X is equal to minus b value. Again minus sign is there. Minus 2 root 2. In place of b, minus 2 root 2. Plus or minus root b square minus 4ac. We have found out here. It is 0. So you can substitute here 0 divided by 2 into a value is 2. A value is 2. There you can substitute here. 2 into 2. So x is equal to minus or minus plus 2 root 2 plus or minus root of 0 is 0 only divided by 4. So now you have two values. X is equal to 2 root 2 plus 0, same value. Or x is equal to 2 root 2 minus 0, it is same only, divided by 4. So you can cancel this one. 2. So x is equal to, you are having root 2 by 2. Here also x is equal to root 2 by 2. So you are getting equal roots here. Observe that when the value of b square minus 4ac is equal to 0 and you are getting two equal roots. In that examples, the earlier examples, you have seen that one. See, look at this. When the b square minus 4ac is a negative number, then you are having no roots. When b square minus 4ac is greater than 0 and a perfect square number, it's a square number, perfect square number, you are getting a rational roots. If it is not a square number, maybe irrational number. But once it is greater than 0, b square minus 4ac value is greater than 0, you will get a real roots. You are getting real roots. Once if this is a negative number, you will not get a real roots. Once this is equal to 0, in the third question we found out if this b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, then the roots are also equal. So this b square minus 4ac determines the nature of the roots. Okay, so b square minus 4ac determines the nature of roots. Therefore, it is called as discriminant. We call it as discriminant. So b square minus 4ac, which decides the nature of the roots. So what are the natures? If b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, that means it's a positive value, the roots are real. Roots are real. If b square minus 4ac greater than or equal to 0, even if it is equal to 0, roots are real only. If b square minus 4ac is less than 0, the roots are not real. Roots are not real. If b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, the roots are equal. And also real. Even it is equal to 0, roots are real. And the special nature, the roots are equal. Both the roots will be equal. So this will determine the nature of the roots, therefore it is called as a discriminant. So b square minus 4 is greater than or equal to 0 means the roots are always real roots. Maybe rational number or irrational number. If the b square minus 4ac is a perfect square number, then you will get a rational number. If that is not a perfect square number, you will get an irrational number. Understand? If this is a square number, you will get rational roots. If this is not a square number, irrational roots. But whatever may be, that your roots are real. B square minus 4ac is a negative number, less than 0, then no real roots exist there. If b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, it is real only, but the roots are equal. So therefore, b square minus 4ac is deciding the nature of the roots. We call this as a discriminant. By looking at b square minus 4ac itself, we can decide the nature of the roots.